come out of our mouth with a lot of forethought. Some of us have more of those days than others. Bill Engvall suggests that those are the types of people who are the reasons why we have so many warning labels. Like that you're not supposed to use your hair dryer while you're in the shower. Or while you're sleeping. And that you shouldn't put preparation H in your mouth. He thinks those sorts of people ought to wear signs that say that they're stupid. That way the rest of us can look out for them and help make sure they don't fall over any cliffs or anything. And maybe we can stay out of their way sometimes too. You know the type of people. Like when you are at the mall, standing in line to see Santa, there's lots of elves, there's a man in a white beard and a red suit, and someone comes up to you. You waiting to see Santa?
Oh,
no, it's a Kenny Rogers impersonator. Here's your sign.
Damn.
Or you're leaving a store after buying a decorative Christmas tree wreath, and someone asks, are you going to hang that on your door?
Oh my goodness.
No, it's a toilet seat cover. Got the idea from Martha Stewart. Here's your sign. Or you pull up at the Christmas tree lot with your family, and the sales clerk asks you, y'all here to buy a Christmas tree?
Yeah.
No, we were just driving by and little Billy had to go to the bathroom and your trees looked awfully inviting. Here's your sign. I wouldn't be surprised if I collected a fair share of those signs. Signs are helpful though, aren't they? Mm-hmm. They let us know things that we need to know. Like that sandwich in the refrigerator that you had nothing to do with is maybe for somebody else. They help prevent traffic accidents. They let us know what hours businesses are open. They let us know where we are and where we're going and how many miles to where we're going. And so many other things. They give us important information that is essential in our living together in harmony with one another. Well, in the scripture today, we meet two people who are wearing different sorts of signs. Or maybe rather, they are different sorts of signs. Isaiah speaks of being sent to proclaim the good news to the oppressed. And the same with John the Baptizer. John came to bear witness to the light. His job was to share the good news of God in Christ. His mission was not to be the light, but to point to the light.
The light of God.
And to teach others to have hope and anticipate and get ready and be prepared for the light. We can imagine Isaiah and John wearing signs that say, you want to know what God is like? Do you want to know the Messiah? Look here. And then they duck and get out of the way. And we come smack face to face with the light. Because of the way these two lived their lives as signs, we are able to believe in a God who is light. We are able to know God as described by Isaiah. A God who binds the brokenhearted, who proclaims liberty to the captive, who comforts those who mourn, and who loves justice. And so, brothers and sisters, I have to ask, what sort of signs do we wear? What do our lives point to? There is a quote, I'm not sure who said it first. Be careful how you act. You may be the only Bible someone reads. I'll say that again just in case you missed it. Be careful how you act. You may be the only Bible someone reads. How does that sit with you? A little pressure. It makes you think, doesn't it? What passage from Scripture do our lives represent? What would a stranger learn about God based on our lives, based on our actions? Or not just a stranger, friends and acquaintances who know that we identify as being Christians and know that we show up here to worship occasionally, maybe more than occasionally, what would they glean about our faith based on what we do and say? What sort of information do we share through our lives that is essential in living together in harmony with God and with one another? Because you see, in our baptism, we have been called to the same job as Isaiah and John, to point to the light, to be a sign. As beloved children of God, we have been appointed to proclaim, to share the good news of God in Christ through word and deed, so that by our actions of serving all people, we point to Jesus. And when we strive for justice and peace in all the world, we are signs of God's love and mercy. And so this third Sunday in Advent, we rejoice. We're full of joy and we lean towards the light, experiencing God's peace, which surpasses all understanding, giving thanks for Jesus, came to be a sign to let us know the good news that we have a God who loves us, who knows us, who forgives us, and who wants to be with us so much that God came to us in Jesus, Emmanuel, which means God with us. And so as we go out into the world, we are careful how we act as we put on our signs. What sign? Beloved children of God, You have been sealed by the Holy Spirit and marked by the cross of Christ forever. Here's your sign. Let it shine. Amen.
That's beautiful, Pastor.
Amen.